For a long time, the holy grail in running was to be the first person to run 4 minutes for the mile, and Roger Bannister did that in 1954.
And Bannister has done it.
At that point, people were running marathons too, but they were running marathons in, 2 hours and 15 minutes, and then 2 hours and 10 minutes, and then got down to about 2 hours and 5 minutes for the world record, and people said, I wonder if people can break 2 hours for the marathon. Eliud Kipchoge, in fact, has run a marathon, the marathon distance, in under 2 hours, but he did that in a special sort of set-up exhibition race. In a way, the two-hour marathon has already been achieved, but immediately after he finished, the goal changed, and the goal became, let's see if we can break 2 hours under normal circumstances. We've been really interested in this two-hour marathon and just the energetic cost of running for myself personally for decades. A lot of what we've done has been basic science, trying to understand how the muscles function, how the tendons act like springs to store and return energy. It is fun to take sort of cold facts and bring them into an emotional sporting event. We can improve the efficiency. We can reduce the amount of energy that it takes to run at a certain speed. And one of the ways that we can do that is to use drafting. To have people running in front of me to break the wind. Runners need to, even though they're competitors, in order to run faster, they need to cooperate. Helping your competitor allows you to raise the bar on your performance. When we run through still air at the speeds that Kipchoge does, the force is just about 1% of my body weight. We could calculate that if we reduced the energy cost by that much, how much faster Kipchoge could run. And it turns out it's about 3 to 4 minutes. Some people might say that trying to break 2 hours for a marathon is just silly. It's just a number. It's not an important thing for society. But it's a goal, and it's an achievable goal, in my opinion. And it encourages all of us to not accept our limitations, but to strive to do our very best. You shouldn't let society put limits on you. You should try to set your sights as high as you can.